Space invaders, your new neighbors are staging a hostile takeover. Oh.
This is ridiculous. We were here first. What about my patients?
Oh, who has time for patients when you can't find parking?
Patrice, are you all right?
Corns, I had to walk to work. No parking.
The resistance is failing. A black sedan just captured your space. Plus, we got a little girl with a sprained ankle in two.
All right, you take the little girl. I'm gonna go talk to them.
No, no, these people can be reasoned with. This is war. Now go teach someone a lesson.
All right, cover me.
Sick 'em, sit.
Yes, it is. Luckily, we are in for more of the same all week.
Thanks for the weather report. Where are the cornflakes?
Up the bag.
What are you, like, running away from home?
I'm taking Tina to the mountains for a few days. Neil's letting us use his cabin.
So you thought you'd embezzle last week's shopping trip?
Pete's off at his dad's, you know? This is our first real chance to be alone together. I want everything to be perfect.
And nothing says romance like canned beans and Cheez-Its.
Morning, Dad.
Hi, Rob.
Did you lose something?
Yes, actually. Fearless.
Hi.
Hi, Sid. Is Fearless visiting you by any chance?
No, sorry. Huh. Is that clock right? As far as I know, it's a rush. It's only 7:30.
New tenants just rented the office space behind St. Clair's. Somebody keeps stealing my parking spot.
Is nothing sacred?
Apparently not. Maybe I'll beat him to it this morning, or at least get a glimpse of the enemy.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Good morning, Heather. Have you... Well, there you are. Phyllis, I've been looking all over for you. It's time for your morning walk. Yeah.
I think something's bothering him.
What do you mean?
Normally, when I come in, he's happy to see me. And lately, I haven't gotten so much as a wag. Hmm. It's like he's depressed about something.
Hey, you're a dog, not a teenager. Yeah. Probably has more to do with the switch from puppy food to adult diet.
It feels more like an identity crisis, like he needs more out of life.
I rather suspect it's an inability to absorb nutrients. However, just to be safe, I'll give him a complete physical.
You're the doctor, Dr. Hansen.
Thank you. Come on, pal.
Unbelievable.
I was just about to page you.
I'm sorry. I've been searching all over for a parking meter. This has got to stop happening.
You want me to make a call? See if I can straighten the new neighbors out?
Yes. I wrote down the license plate number. Meanwhile, there's a young mother and her baby waiting in, too.
Well, baby visit?
I don't think so. He's 14 weeks and barely 9 pounds.
Oh. Well, let's take a look. Mrs. Wilson?
Diane.
Hi, Diane. I'm Dr. Hansen. I see this is your first visit with us.
I just moved here.
This must be Tyler.
He hasn't been himself since we moved.
Let me take a look at him. What do you mean by he hasn't been himself?
He just seems so weak. He used to take at least 4 ounces from his bottle, but now he's down to
it's
2.
Okay, shh. Was he a full-term delivery?
Yes, 7 pounds, 14 ounces. When I had him checked out 6 weeks ago, he was over 10. But he's so skinny now.
Okay, I'd like to arrange for Tyler to see a specialist at University Hospital today. His muscle tone is considerably less than I'd expect for a 14-week-old, and I'm concerned about his weight loss.
It's okay, sweetie. It's okay.
Turns out our neighbors are campaign headquarters for some political group. I couldn't get a straight answer on the car, so I called the tow truck.
I've got more important things to worry about right now.
That little baby?
Yeah. Let's get a SMAC-12 and CBC stat. Page Dr. Timmons at university. I'd like her to take a look at him. The sooner the better.
Hey.
Hey.
Ow! Tell ya, something about a woman wearing flannel.
Well, I've never seen the grizzly Adam side of you.
I live for the great outdoors.
I've always been more of a city girl.
You're gonna love it. There's no phones, no work, no mom duties. Just you, me, and absolute wilderness.
Where no one can hear me scream?
Relax, honey, you're dealing with a pro.
I know.
All right, I'll drive you to navigate.
Okay.
Okay, get in. These are gonna be the best 3 days of your life.
Got the directions?
I must have left him inside.
Nice of you to show. Half day?
Don't start. I'm having enough trouble just keeping it together as it is.
What's the latest crisis?
The mother of them all, literally, my mom is coming to visit town tomorrow.
Oh, that's great. Bring her by. I would love to meet the woman that spawned this.
Sorry, she knows nothing about my professional embarrassment in canine cuisine.
What does she think you do?
We don't discuss it. She remains blissfully ignorant of all aspects of my life. That's how we've managed to stay so close over the years.
Sounds healthy.
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with your eye?
What? My... Damn it! The twitch is back! Is it hot in here, or is it just me? Cool stream on a warm spring day.
Elliot, when you say your mother is unaware of your life, well, you have discussed the obvious, right?
Never.
Did you try maybe writing her a letter?
I've written the letters, but I've never actually sent them. I'm just not butch enough to follow through. But you are. Why don't you come with me to lunch tomorrow?
Elliot, I'm not outing you to your mother.
Oh, come on.
No way!
Oh, please.
No.
Then at least just be there for moral support.
Okay.
Oh, great.
Who's in charge?
Sorry, miss, but there's a line of people in front of you.
Someone at this address has authorized a towing company to take a very important vehicle from our lot.
That someone would be me, and that space would belong to us.
What's going on? This woman made a colossal mistake. The car she had towed from our parking area belongs to future Rhode Island Senator, Congressman Joe Connolly.
Joe Connolly's the one who's been stealing my spot? I actually voted for him.
Then I can only imagine how ridiculous you must feel.
That I voted for him?
Dr. Hansen, that was a lab about the baby's blood work this morning. They found an unusually high level of creatine in his system. They're faxing over the reports now.
All right, Izzy, make sure that Dr. Timmons at university gets a copy of that fax. She needs to do a muscle biopsy right away.
I'm on it.
Hey, excuse me. I am here on official business.
Who's next?
I swear, I copied the directions down exactly the way O'Neill told me.
I believe you. I'm just happy to be out of the car.
Man, the forecast said it was going to be gorgeous today. Wow.
check this place out. Oh. I guess no one's been here in a while. So, what do you think?
It's, cozy.
Yeah. Why don't you unpack the food in the fridge? See if I can't start a little fire. Maybe we can crack open a little bottle of wine, you know, slip out of these wet clothes.
Keep talking.
Man, it is really coming down out there.
And a little bit in here.
Huh? Oh. Vintage cabin like this is bound to have a few cracks. Just need something to, catch the rain. Perfect. So, where was I?
Oh,
don't worry about that. The barometric pressure is a lot less stable in the high country. In the storms like this, they just fizzle out as quickly as they form.
Dr. Timmons is on the phone. She's prepping Tyler Wilson for the muscle biopsy. Wants to know if you'd like to be there.
Right. Beth. Yes, I would. Okay, I'm on my way. About 20 minutes. Thanks.
I'm looking for Sid Hansen.
Hi, Dr. Hansen.
Hi, Joe Connolly. I'm your new neighbor. It seems we had a misunderstanding over a parking place this morning.
You know, this is really a bad time.
I understand. I'm a busy guy myself, which is why I sent over a volunteer to deal with this earlier, but apparently she met with some resistance.
Let's make this simple. Why don't you have your people park in the half of the parking lot that's closest to your building, and I'll have my patients and employees do the same.
I must have twice the staff you have, plus frequent meetings with high-ranking officials. Dividing the lot 50-50, it seems inequitable.
So should I tell your constituents here that your political aspirations are more important than their health? Or would you care to do that? I didn't think so.
Here's where you can see the buildup of glycogen in Tyler's muscle cells. I've only had one other case. 11-month-old girl came in last year.
What'd you do for her?
Well, there's very little to be done. Although I did stumble on a successful drug study in Boston. Unfortunately, it was only in phase one and my patient wasn't a candidate.
What happened to her?
She died of aspiration pneumonia a month later. These kids rarely see their second birthday.
What about the drug study?
Ongoing, as far as I know. I can get you the number, but you know how political these trials can be. And with Tyler in such an advanced stage, it could be difficult to get him in.
Diane Wilson's here.
Send her in.
I'll call you with that number.
Thank you, Beth. Please sit down.
I got him to eat this morning. Not a full bottle, but that's a good sign, right? Maybe it was just a bug after all.
I'm afraid it's more serious than that. Tyler has something called glycogen enzyme deficiency. That's why he's been so weak. And right now, there is no known treatment for it.
Are you saying he's gonna die?
Diane, there is some hope. A new drug is being tested in Boston, and I'm gonna do everything in my power to get Tyler into that trial. In the meantime, I wanna add MCT oil to his formula to get his weight back up.
Morning, Noah.
Morning. Hey, told you it would blow over.
Everything in this place is soaked.
It'll dry. Just let the mountain breeze air it out. Something smells fantastic.
Cinnamon oatmeal.
I love cinnamon oatmeal. Wow, would you look at that? It's absolutely gorgeous outside. Now that the weather's cleared up, we're gonna have a great time.
So, what is the plan exactly?
I say we finish getting ready right now, and we head out for a little morning hike.
Right now, now? What about breakfast?
Just a 20-minute jaunt to get the blood flowing. We'll keep this warm on the stove, and by the time I get back, we'll have worked up a real appetite.
Okay.
Okay, get your shoes on.
cool stream on a warm spring day. Cool stream on a warm spring day.
Well, you cut that out already.
Oh my God, there she is. I can't do this.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can, Elliot. Unless your mother is deaf, dumb, and blind, she already knows. This is gonna be a huge relief.
Promise me, no matter what I say or do, she leaves knowing the truth.
I promise.
Okay. Mom!
Elliot! Oh, Elliot! Oh, look at you!
Oh, ow!
Oh, my! Oh,
you look fabulous!
Well, I've been shopping. Who knew you'd have such quaint boutiques? Well, you must be Joan.
Hi.
You know, you're the first girl that Elliot's introduced me to since... Well, I can't even remember.
Oh, come on, come on.
How about that?
Joanie's the reason that I'm staying here in Providence.
Well, she must be very special. Now, what's good?
Oh, yes, you're right. The menu. Let's talk about the menu.
Elliot.
This is a beautiful restaurant. I don't think we've been here before.
Elliot.
Oh, can you please wait until dessert?
You promised me. I promised.
I am more grounded when
there's
dessert.
What are you two whispering about? It's not nice to have secrets.
You're right, Mom. It's not. And this is a big one. Joanie and I are in love, and we're going to be married.
What?
No, no, Mrs. Anderman. As fond as I am of your son, we actually are not getting married. And there's
what?
A very good reason as to why we are not getting married. And that reason would be...
Mom, I'm gay. You have a gay son. Everybody ready to hear our specials?
Yes, I know this is my third message, but it's imperative that Dr. Carroll call me back.
Right. Thank you.
Still no luck. How difficult is it to return one phone call? Mr. Conley.
I'll try contacting a research coordinator. Sometimes papers happen faster when it's nurse to nurse.
Thanks.
Sounds like you're tangled in some red tape.
I'm trying to get a sick baby into a drug trial in Boston, but I guess I'm gonna have to go up there myself. If this is about the parking thing,
actually, it is. A structure down the block offered us a deal, so all we'll need here is one or two spaces. Truce?
Welcome to the neighborhood.
Thank you. It's a good idea, by the way.
Excuse me?
Going to Boston. My entire day consists of asking people for help in one way or another. I found they're more likely to listen if you're face to face. Good luck.
Thanks.
Well, it's the picture of health. I just don't understand it.
It's ennui. It's French for malaise.
I can't think of any reason why he should be depressed. It just doesn't make any medical sense. And besides, golden retrievers aren't usually moody animals.
Hi, Dr. Hansen.
Stephanie.
Easy, Toby. This is my Aunt Mary. She's visiting for the week.
Mary, nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Please sit down.
Thank you.
Her guide dog, Toby, woke with a limp this morning. We were hoping you could squeeze him in.
Oh, sure. Shouldn't be any problem. Heather, would you take Fearless out back for some exercise? Toby, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Come on, Toby. Let's see what the problem is.
Come on, Fearless.
No, what's the matter with you? A tetrahydrocannabinol. Medical marijuana.
For my glaucoma. Well, it's perfectly legal where I come from.
Oh, I'm sure it is. Fearless just must have smelled it as he walked by. I'm very sorry.
Well, no harm done.
It's like having our very own police dog.
Lucky us.
Good boy, Fearless!
I'm sorry, okay? I could have sworn that the cabin was south of the creek.
I know. You've been swearing that for the last 4 hours of our 20-minute walk.
I guess I should have packed the compass.
Did you leave the door open?
Yeah, to air it out, remember? But don't worry, there aren't any people around here for miles. Our stuff is safe.
I was right about one thing. I certainly worked up an appetite.
I'm as hungry as a...
Dr. Carroll?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, I'm Dr. Hansen from Providence. I've left several messages for you today.
Right. Beth Timmons' colleague.
I understand you've had some success in treating glycogen enzyme deficiency with a new drug protocol.
True.
I was hoping you'd enter one of my patients into your trial.
Trial is closed.
Well, this is a 14-week-old with failure to thrive. Perhaps you could make an exception.
I wish I could, but it's not up to me. There simply isn't enough of the drug available.
I don't understand.
GED is a very rare condition. It affects less than 6,000 children nationwide.
I'm aware of that.
Well, then you're also aware of the fact that the drug I'm testing stands precious little chance of ever reaping a profit for the company that developed it.
Well, that may be so, but if it's effective, then
Dr.
we have
Hansen,
to...
Dr. Hansen, Zydex only provided me with enough glyphenerol to treat 6 children. 6. We initially approved 20 into the program.
I see.
I'm sorry you had to come all this way for bad news, but...
It's out of your hands.
So I'm supposed to just sit back and watch my baby die?
He can just hold on until the trial is completed. The pharmaceutical company...
If he can hold on. He needs this medicine now. Even I can see that.
Diane, how long has he been coughing like this?
On and off since this morning. Some of that new formula went down the
wrong pipes. Izzy, get Dr. Timmons on the phone. Tell her she needs to set up a chest x-ray for Tyler. He'll probably need to be admitted. Right away.
Why?
Sometimes babies in his condition are prone to aspiration pneumonia. I just want to be safe.
Hello? Bear? It's all clear. It's finally gone.
Oh my God, look at this place.
Well, luckily I brought the pack with the beef jerky and the blankets yesterday. This one's all gear.
Huh, look at that. I did pack a compass.
Robbie, I think we should head back to civilization where we belong. Maybe find a nice hotel room with room service, or at least running water.
Come on, don't let a few minor setbacks ruin this for us.
We could have been mauled.
That bear is long gone. We're not in any danger anymore. You know, I mean, let's just give it one more night. Ah. A cookie dinner.
Pork and beans.
Yeah! Come on, this is the staple of rustic life.
Well, we must have used the rest of the propane keeping the oatmeal warm for gentle Ben.
Bye-bye. Elliot, where have you been? What happened yesterday?
It's all a blur. I was kind of hoping you'd tell me.
Well, the last I saw, your mom excused herself to the bathroom, and then you followed her in.
Right. Well, after the maitre d' escorted me to the street, she followed me out, disowned me on the curb, and then hailed a cab.
She did not.
What does "you're no son of mine" then "taxi" mean to you?
Well, have you talked to her since?
She told the hotel clerk not to take my calls. Do you mind if I go home? I'm not feeling very well.
No, go ahead. Are you gonna be okay?
I don't know. I've never been orphaned before.
Okay, Mrs. Weingart's calico is ready. How's Fearless?
Listless.
Hmm?
Dr. Hansen, you can't ignore it any longer. Fearless has a higher calling in law enforcement.
Heather, Fearless is a family pet. Family pets are not supposed to be sniffing around flop houses and airports looking for concealed drugs. It's not in their nature.
How can you say that? You saw the high it gave him when he uncovered Mrs. Jane's stash. Now look at him. Did Robbie ever excel in any activity at school?
My Robbie?
Like a sport. Something that you might not have approved of initially, But then you let him do it because it meant so much to him and because you loved him?
No.
Well, Fearless has a gift and you shouldn't hold him back. You owe it to him to investigate his potential.
As a police dog?
As a fulfilled animal. The canine trainer's name is Officer Duncan. Just think about it.
Go on without me. I'll catch up with you in a few minutes. Need some help?
No, thanks. I got it.
Oh, come on. What good is your congressman if he can't help you change your tire?
Yeah, it's probably one of your people who did this in the first place.
Yeah, that's part of my new campaign. Vote for me or I'll slash your tires.
I'm sorry. It's just bad timing, you know? Things like this always happen when you're in a hurry.
Murphy's Law. I'll try and get that one repealed. So how'd it go in Boston the other day? Did that kid get in?
Study's closed. I'm on my way to the pharmaceutical company to petition them to release more of the drug.
You're one hell of an advocate.
Never dealt directly with a pharmaceutical exec before.
Just state your case. Don't take no for an answer.
There's a child's life hanging in the balance. Can't stand the thought of what'll happen if I come up empty.
Good. Because if you could stand the thought, you might turn around and leave when they tell you no. Look at that. Would you look at that? I did it.
You're kidding.
Who's the mountain man now?
Yeah.
Is there supposed to be so much smoke?
Maybe the log's just a little wet.
Oh, I'll fan them off a little bit. No.
That's it. I'm out of here. I'm tired, I'm hungry, and I'm freezing.
Where are you going?
The car, to get warm, and to see if Petey maybe left a piece of candy wedged in the seat. Are you coming?
It's open. Bags are by the door. Please be careful with the Prada.
It's Joni Hansen, Mrs. Anderman. Heading back to Chicago?
That's right.
Were you going to say goodbye to Elliot?
I don't see what concern that is of yours.
He's my friend. He's upset.
That's not my fault.
Actually, it is. You turned your back on him when he was just trying to be honest with you.
I don't need you to tell me about my son. As far as I'm concerned, Elliot is no longer the child I raised.
Well, hallelujah. Because you raised him to hide who he really is to please you. He can't do that anymore. He shouldn't have to do that anymore.
Are you quite finished?
No. Elliot did a really brave thing yesterday. And he loves you. Do you really want to punish him for that?
Is it Hansen?
It's Beth.
Your instinct was right. Tyler does have aspiration pneumonia.
Oh, damn. I just admitted him.
How's his mother? Upset?
She's been asking for you.
Tell her I'm at Zyadex now. I'm about to plead Tyler's case.
Tyler's fever spiked to 103. I've got him on ceftriaxone, but...
I'm just not sure he's strong enough to fight off this infection.
I'll be there as soon as I can.
Okay. Dr. Hansen.
Hi.
Mr. Peterson is going to have to reschedule.
No, that's unacceptable. This is a matter of life and death.
I'm sorry.
If I could just have 2 minutes of his time...
He's simply not available for you today. If you'd like to schedule a formal appointment, I have an opening next Wednesday.
Look, if I don't get some glyphenerol today, a 14-week-old baby is going to die. Do you want that on your conscience?
I don't respond to threats, Dr. Hansen. And I'm quite sure Mr. Peterson won't either.
I am not threatening you.
Do I need to call security?
No.
Then I'll put you down for Wednesday at 10. Good day.
Come on, Fearless, let's go. Come on, come on, come on, Fearless. Come on, Fearless. Come on, Fearless, let's go.
Fearless, what am I going to do with you?
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
What's wrong with him?
Oh, evidently he's depressed because I'm holding him back from his true calling. You okay?
I was up half the night at the hospital with a sick infant. I've run out of ideas of how to help him.
I'm sorry, sweetie. But if anyone can pull it out, you can. No one is more resourceful when the chips are down.
Mm. I think my resources are all tapped out on this.
Well, I'm not going to bet against you.
You wouldn't bet against any of us. Cheer up, Fearless. Dad would never hold a handsome back. It's not in his nature.
I'm such a jerk. None of this went the way that I planned.
Well, that's comforting, because we'd have a serious conflict of interest if it had. Can we go home now?
I wanted to make these few days memorable, romantic. I'll take our relationship to the next level. Instead, I end up putting you through the ego challenge.
It's okay, Robbie. You don't have to prove anything to me. I'm already hooked.
You are?
Mm-hmm. So stop trying so hard and get over here.
See, the tire held up.
Yeah, it did. Thanks.
So how'd it go with the drug exec?
Well, I didn't even make it past the secretary. So much for not taking no for an answer. Well, I was just gonna pick up a few things on my way to the hospital.
I have a meeting.
Congressman, this is your district, right?
Yeah.
And that would make me your constituent. And in essence, you work for me.
That's right.
Then I'd like to make a request. I want you to call the drug company on my patient's behalf. The executive VP of product development may not want to listen to a doctor from a clinic, but I have a feeling he'll listen to you. His name is John Peterson. The office is right downtown.
Zyadex.
Please. I really have no other recourse. This little boy is dying.
I'll need to get some more information. Can I call you at the clinic?
Absolutely.
I'm so afraid to let go of his hand. Ever since his father took off, it's just been the two of us. I just don't want him to know that I can't do anything for him now. You've done everything in your power to help us. I wish I could do more. What's happening?
Just move back. He's in respiratory distress.
Oh, my God. Tyler, hold on. Please.
Diane, you need to wait outside. I'm sorry.
Let's get him into ICU. We're going to have to innovate. Move. Let's go.
I've got the
ambulance
back in the
ICU. Sid, are you sure you want to intubate this baby?
As long as there's still a chance to get the glyphenerol.
A realistic one?
I'm not ready to give up on him.
All right.
So far, Fearless has excelled in all the preliminary tests for our canine training program.
You realize he hasn't had any formal instruction.
I'm curious to see Fearless's instincts in action. So I've hidden a typical transit article somewhere in the yard that contains a small amount of tetrahydrocannabinol.
Ganja. Fearless's drug of choice.
Let's just let Officer Duncan conduct his test.
Okay, Fearless, here you go. Let's see if you got a nose for this stuff. Come on. Okay. That's it, that's it. Okay, let's see what you got.
I can run with the big dogs, or lay on the porch, lay here and not even move. I've been over the road and under the house. I ain't got nothing to prove.
Well, appears that all Fearless has a nose for today is last Sunday's cookout. Sorry you wasted a trip, Officer Duncan.
Fearless is a prime candidate for the program. We'd be lucky to have him.
Oh my God! Good dog!
Got any papers?
Here you go. We've got Tyler on a ventilator. I don't want my baby to suffer, Dr. Hansen. I don't know what to do.
Yeah, Dr. Hansen, Joe Connolly's here looking for you.
We'll put him on.
Hey.
Hi.
Yeah, good news.
Zydex agreed to release the drug.
We got Tyler's medicine.
All they need is an address for the courier.
It can be delivered into business today.
No couriers.
I'll pick it up myself. Just have them leave it at reception. Okay, thanks. Bye. Tell Dr. Timmons I went to pick up the drug.
I'm slaving!
Now!
Okay.
What are you doing here?
A little birdie told me where I could find you.
I'm gonna go clean spatulas.
No, please, stay put. I only have a minute.
I suppose we can't just forget about what happened the other day.
I'm afraid that's quite impossible. Seems I'm just beginning to discover who my boy really is.
That's okay.
I'm going to get you the number of a doctor that I heard about in Boston.
Mother, there is nothing wrong with me. I don't need a doctor.
I hear from my bridge ladies that he's quite the looker, and he's available.
What? Oh.
Oh. Oh. Oh, I'm gonna miss my flight. So I'll see you at Christmas?
Maybe sooner.
I love your place here, Joan. Look after my boy for me.
I think he can take care of himself.
Yes, I suppose he can.
Dr. Hansen.
Page Dr. Timmons' dad. Tell her I'm back. Sid, I got it, Beth.
It's too late.
What?
Tyler coded.
No.
We brought him back 3 times, but his little heart couldn't take it.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance. It's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release.
Why don't you get into bed, dear?
I always like this chair. Remember when I was little and we used to sit here together? You'd play with my curls until I fell asleep?
Comfy chair, you used to call it. You had a rough one today. I know sometimes it's hard to find a silver lining.
That's because this time there wasn't one.
Don't be so sure. Crossing paths with that mother and child has had a deep impact on your life. More than you realize right now.
What are you trying to tell me, Mom?
You'll understand in time. But let's not worry about it tonight.
Can you stay a while?
All night, if you like.
Thank you.